What's up, guys? Middle Age Gamer here. We're going to continue on with the Transport Fever series right now, and we're going to be doing the America campaign. Now, we are going to skip the Motor Industry mission, which is technically the next one, because this metal right here is broken in the current release. Until they fix that, I'm not going to do an upload on this particular video. So we're going to go to Airmail Scandal right here. You can see I played it once right now. I missed the Aviation Pioneer, which has finished the mission before 1943. I was off by like a couple of months, I think. So it's actually a fairly easy mission to accomplish. There's a couple things that you may or may not know how to do, and there's just a lot of routes that you have to set up to complete the entire mission. Let's go ahead and get into it, and I'll show you guys how to do this as a quick walkthrough. Keep in mind, I do recommend you guys play the mission at least once or twice before you watch my video. There's 100 different ways you could do this mission. I'm just going to show you what I do to get all 5 medals at once, and hopefully it helps you guys out there if you have any questions as well. Keep in mind, you can always comment and ask questions below if you need to. So anyways, it's 1925. Aviation's making a huge progress, and we have to do basically 5 medals. Let's go and start the mission though and get into it. And I do recommend you listen to all the chatting and talking so you can learn about what exactly to do. But basically we have to obtain landing permission at the 5 airports in Santa Barbara, LA, Vegas, Phoenix, San Diego. And once you do that, it kind of opens up a whole list of other things you can do. And you have to click on the question mark of each city to figure out what you need to do. So we're gonna go basically from city to city and break it up into small chunks. Again, it's gonna be a lot of routes that you have to set up and a lot of routes that you have to watch over time. So let's go ahead and click on Los Angeles question mark real quick. So basically we have to deliver machines to the Los Angeles area. This one's actually fairly easy. It's just a lot, again, things you have to set up in particular. So obviously we need steel to make the machines over here. We can make steel or slag, I believe that is, but we need iron and coal. And you can see the iron and coal are up here. So again, we have to make a bunch of different routes to bring the iron and coal down to the factory here at the steel mill, transport the steel over to the machine factory, and then transport the machines actually back into LA to the industrial section. And to see what the industrial section is, you could transport it over here or right here, probably would be best for LA. Anyways, let's go ahead and set up a couple different routes. This is obviously what we need to do. And I'm going to put the depot down here first and foremost. Not going to worry about upgrading the roads. I'm going to keep the current road system. It's actually plenty for what we're going to be doing. And let's go ahead and set a bus route right here. This is what we're going to actually do to drop off the coal and the iron right here. And let's do another drop off over here for the steel. And then also one more drop off for the industrial area, which we'll do over here. Go through the main part of LA, which should be fine. Now we got to set up the freight stations, or truck stations as they call it. And let's see, so we're dropping off there. We could set up the truck station over here. And then we'll set up 2 smaller ones up here for the coal plant, or coal mine, I should say. And I'll set up one for the iron ore mine up here. Try to save as much money as possible. You really don't have to worry about it too much. You got, again, 25 million to start off with. You do have to pay 5 million up front, which I'll go over that here in a bit. So I think we're pretty much ready to set up some vehicles. Again, we're gonna use the Mac AC. This is actually gonna be one of the most profitable routes right here. Let's go ahead and start with 5 for now. Then we can always upgrade it. And it's the this is the hard part, actually, is doing each single line. Okay. Let's get on that. Let's go ahead and buy some more vehicles. Set up 5 for the coal mine. There you go. I don't really like how all the trucks are going through here, but I think with the large station, it'll actually go around the ones that are loading, so it should be okay. So we've got 5 doing that. I'm just going to buy probably 1 for now, which will go from the factory there to drop off steel at the machine factory. Actually, I'll buy probably 2 more. And I forgot to set a truck station over here, which I need to do that as well. This is going to be for the machines. And let's go ahead and buy just 2 vehicles for this again. It's going to take the machines to the industrial area in LA. And doing all this will actually grant permission to use this airport once you deliver 100 machines to the industrial section of LA. One thing I'm going to do while I'm in LA is I'm actually going to set up a passenger route for the buses. Very important you get this going early on. That way you eventually, when you set up the airport, you have passengers waiting to get on the planes. That's kind of the part I messed up in the previous scenario or previous mission that I did on here. So most importantly, go ahead and set up 1 station out by the airport. Very important that you do that. And I'm just going to do a couple various places over here. There we go. Don't really need too many buses starting off, but let's go ahead and just buy 1 or 2. And we'll use the Mac for these. Let's do 3. Hopefully these will be profitable. We'll find out. All right, so let's go through all these real quick. There we go. So that's it for LA. That's set up now. Let's go ahead and go on to the next one, which is Santa Barbara. This one's actually probably the easiest. So you have to find the poker ship off the coast, which is right here. And you got to bet $5 million playing poker to gain access to this airport. You're going to lose the $5 million, of course. There you go. So we already obtained landing permission at 1 airport. That one's obviously the easiest one. So Santa Barbara set up. What you do want to do in Santa Barbara, though, is actually set up this line. This would be your probably second most profitable route, which is transporting corn or grain, and livestock over to the farm, which makes food. And you're going to transport the food all the way down to Santa Barbara. Again, you can get really creative. You can just transport the food to Santa Barbara. You could transport it to a train station there, transport the food over to LA. You can do all sorts of different things. But to keep it simple, we're just going to basically set up a few lines over here and transport the food to Santa Barbara. So let's set up a bus stop down here to drop everything off. And we also need a truck station as well. There we go. Let's go and do a large truck station here. Trying to keep costs down as much as possible. And then we need 2 more small truck stations for each of these areas. Go, and then we need a bus station down here where they need food, which I think is the commercial district. Yep. So we'll just put a bus station down here, and we'll set up a couple other bus stations as well since we're down here in the area. Again, you need 1 at the airport, which is very, very important. All right. And And I'm going to go ahead and set up another truck depot so I don't have to use the one over there. They're relatively inexpensive to do it. So let's go ahead and set this up. And we'll set up the routes. So again, a couple max. We'll do maybe two on each line initially. So this one will just go from here to there. Again, you're going to have a ton of lines on this particular scenario or mission, so just keep that in mind. So I need to buy more vehicles. Let's get two more. Oops, there we go. Set line, new line. Take that up there. I think I keep closing out of the depot. We'll set up three to transport food. Again, I'm probably going to add lots of vehicles on each of these routes eventually over time as things start picking up. And we're going to transport this down to the area right here, which is good. And also we needed to set up a couple buses for the passenger guys, or passengers I should say. Let's go ahead and do that. Again, use the max for now. We'll set up three for the time being. Set line, new line. There we go. So that's all set up right there. Let's go ahead and head to the next city, see what we gotta do. Here we are in San Diego, good sized city right here. You could probably end up doing a rail line back and forth if you wanted to. Again, probably not going to use rails in this particular mission unless things are going really, really good. All right, so you got to deliver fuel to the industrial area of San Diego. You have to deliver 100 fuel. This is the first time we're actually going to use boats. And again, you could get away with just running vehicles to these areas. In fact, that's probably the best option. But because I haven't used boats before, we're going to go ahead and set up a boat route for you guys so you can see what to do. Again, this may not be the best option for you guys, but we're going to do it for this particular scenario. In fact, I know throwing boats at this would probably be 1,000 times easier. I mean, throwing trucks at this instead of boats would be 1,000 times easier. Okay, got one dock there. Now we need to set up two more docks down here. Again, make sure they are freight docks, not passenger docks. Very important you do that. There we go. Set up the road structure right there. And then we're going to do one more dock right here. Boats are very expensive. They're super slow. I'm not really fond of them myself. But at least you guys will be able to check it out. So what we're going to do is set up a boat depot. What do they actually call it? A shipyard. Yeah, boat depot doesn't sound that correct. The problem with boats is I didn't figure out how to actually sell the boat because it can never find a line back into the depot to do that. So I'm just going to buy one ship. We need to go to freight ships only. I can buy the Vandal, $131,000 per year to run, or I can buy the Klondike. I'm going to do the Klondike for now. I can always buy more ships down the road. Let's see the difference, 14 miles per hour and 16, so it's only 2 miles per hour difference. We'll go ahead and buy this, and let's go ahead and set this guy's line up real fast. And have him actually run up here first. Back down, and then we'll run up to this one, and back down again. So that's going to deliver the barrels of oil, I believe it is. Yeah, crude oil to make the fuel. Next thing is next, we got to set up the fuel line to be delivered to the industrial section of San Diego. So click on this little icon. Again, just we can deliver it anywhere right here is really what's going to happen. So let's go ahead and set up a little bus line. Actually, we need to set up this whole neighborhood for bus stations too, so let's go ahead and do that. We'll do one in the industrial section. That should be good right there for bus stations. Oh, we need one at the airport too. Very important we do that. And then we need a truck depot or truck station to unload the fuel here. And let's go ahead and set up another depot so I can add trucks here. Let's go ahead and do, let's just do one truck for now, delivering the fuel to the industrial section. Again, it's going to take a long time for the boat to get all the way down and back to even deliver barrels of oil. So you got to keep that in mind. And let's go ahead and set this guy's lineup. I'm just going to go from right here to here. And he's done. Now let's set up a couple buses again. We'll use the Mac. 1, 2, 3 for now. Set up this guy's line. There we go. Those guys are set up. And that's it for San Diego right there. Let's head up to the next one, which is Phoenix. Again, it seems like a lot that you're doing all at once, but it's better to go ahead and set everything up front before you even hit play, and then you can tweak it as you go. All right, so this is one that kind of got me the first time. I barely got it towards the end. It says, bring tourists to the observation platform at the Grand Canyon. So the Grand Canyon, if I can even find it, let me look at the contour maps, that may help me. I think it's down here somewhere. It's like around a mountain or something. It's like a little tiny building. Let's see if I can actually find it. It's probably over here somewhere. There it is. So we got to bring this road all the way over to Phoenix. This is actually the Grand Canyon in the game. Doesn't really quite look like it to me, but it's not for me to say. So very important to bring up the contour lines. We're going to have to basically bring this road all the way over there. And let's see if I can remember how I even did this last time, because you don't want to build tunnels. Again, just like with train tracks, you want to build it in small sections. Very important you do this. The smaller sections, the better. Best route or not, I can't even tell. It's probably worse ways I could be going. I don't want to be doing that. Probably gonna have to from the looks of it. It's obviously not the best route to go by any means. Gonna do one. Alright, getting closer. See where we actually want to connect, probably just right here by the airport. There we go. And we'll go ahead and set up a passenger station here. We'll do a large one as well, because this will be fairly profitable. Set up a couple more bus stations over here for the rest of Phoenix as well. And we'll set up another road depot. We'll have two different lines, so we'll have a couple in the city. Let's do three again to start off with. There we go. And then we need to buy a lot going to the Grand Canyon. And for that one, I'm going to use the Snyder PB2s. They hold an extra passenger. It's fine, though. Do quite a few starting off. Hopefully, the business will get going fairly soon. So it's going to be going from here all the way down to the Grand Canyon, which I need to set up a bus station down here. Let me go ahead and do that. And then we'll add the station right there. There we go. All right, so that's it for Phoenix right there. I think we got 4 out of 5. Now it's just Vegas we have to worry about. Let's go to Vegas and see what we have to do. All right, deliver construction material for the construction of the Hoover Dam. All right, so basically we've got to deliver bricks or construction material right there for the Hoover Dam. And this guy needs, what does he need? Needs either a stone or slag to make the construction materials. And this guy is actually down here. So again, we need to do another boat route as well for this guy. And it's not really a good place to put this per se. Come on, work with me. Where can I put this? Right there. Okay. Now running this road is going to be a little difficult. A little bit easier. It looks like there's actual tunnel right there. $319,000 to go that far. I could run it probably cheaper, but let's go ahead and do it. Get it over with. We need to set another freight station down here. And hopefully I can set the road up right there without hitting anything. There we go. Perfect. And we do need a truck station there for the construction materials. And we need a bus station down there to drop it off. And let's go ahead and set up, I guess, one or two bus stations here. Definitely need one down there by the airport. Okay. And we need another boatyard or shipyard right here. Okay, we're just going to buy one of the Klondikes right there to go back and forth for now. We can always add another one or upgrade the ship if we need to. Set a new line for this guy all the way down here and then all the way back. There we go. And we'll set up these transports right here. So set up another road depot. Again, we're just going to have probably one for now. Go back and forth because it's going to take a while for this to start producing anything. Set this line right there to there. There we go. And then we need to set up the bus route as well, which we may just have one bus go for this time. It's going to do one bus. Set the line. So I'll go from here. Here, down, and back. All right, so I think that's about it. Let's go ahead and hit play. There may be some issues with how we set something up. Again, we're trying to obtain landing permissions for all 5 airports. Let's hit play for a minute. I'll probably speed it up here in a little bit. I just want to make sure that everything starts off nicely. I want to make sure all the vehicles are coming out, going the proper way. And just be on the lookout for this. There's no warnings, which is good, so everything should have a line for the time being. This is the route we really want to watch the entire time, and we need to add probably a ton of trucks until basically just have trucks going back and forth. I would say maybe 50 to 100, somewhere in there, and a bunch running from the steel plant over to the machine plant as well. And then last but not least, make sure the boats are off and running. As you can see, they're incredibly slow. Love the graphics in this game, though. If you want to get down and look at the detail, I mean, you can definitely get down and see the detail of everything. So that's pretty insane to me. Okay, so things look to be going okay. We already got grain coming out. You can see the little box of grain right there, so that's good. It's already started. And don't waste, I mean, the first time I did this mission, I had 3 or 4 boats on each route. Absolutely did not need it, although I could probably do 2 boats on this particular route. But I'm going to keep it going for now. It should be plenty to do what we need to until we get to the airplane era, where we can start buying airplanes. Lots of traffic bustling down here in San Diego, as you can see. And keep in mind, a lot of these routes will not be profitable for quite a while starting off. And these plants, like the steel mill, will be upgraded over time. The more it does, along with the actual mines, will be upgraded over time as well. The limit's only 100 right now, but it will go up to 200, and then I believe 400 is the next one after that. See, one truck's already picking up plenty, so that's good. Probably go ahead and send another few out right now, even though we don't technically need it quite yet. Just do 3. Buy another 3 as well. There we go. Because what will happen when these 5 guys actually leave, there's going to be a big buildup of coal and iron ore deposits, so it's very important that we start spacing these trucks apart as much as possible. Let's go ahead and speed it up because we got a lot of years to go, and we got to build up this production as quickly as possible. One of the biggest routes is typically this guy right here. You can see there's already people waiting. So let's go ahead and turn some of these guys around so they can start making money. There we go. And then we can increase the amount of taxis, is what I really would call them. Let's go ahead and set this guy's line. I'm not sure which one it is. Again, there's so many lines. There we go, line 13. People we got waiting 40. I might go ahead and add a couple more on the route right there as well, which these are the Sniders. There we go. These guys will all be full of passengers, so we'll actually have to transport people fairly soon, which will unlock the airports where we can start flying and setting up lines. Again, you'll get a bunch of unlocks for different trains throughout this mission. There's really no need to set up any trains unless you want to. I'm sure you can make a route profitable. and make quite a bit more money, but it's not really needed. There you go. So that city's obviously doing really, really good. This guy only has 17 crude oil, so that's why I only have one ship going. It's just because even with three barrels, it's only 21. The ship actually holds 100, and so until this port gets full, there's really no need to do anything more. Let's go look at this route. We probably need to add a couple more to the iron ore. Gotta figure out which one it is. There we go, line one. Hopefully that's good for now. Gonna add one more to transport the steel for the time being. There we go. Let's see how. I don't think we're making machines quite yet, but let's go down and take a look. Nope, not making anything quite yet, so we'll keep that one lonely truck running back and forth for the time being. Look at that, already got 50 people transported, which is good. Probably need to add a few more trucks on this route as well. Go. You can see production is definitely increasing quite a bit when you get this food out of here and down to the city as quickly as possible. Iron ore is getting backed up already, which is good. All right, so let's go ahead and pause it again real quick while I show you this part of the mission. Maybe buy a couple more vehicles for here. Should be good for now, hopefully. All right, so line setup right here is the airmail. And to set up four lines between two cities and deploy a single aircraft on each line, which is pretty much exactly what we're going to do. So we unlocked, I think Phoenix down here. Yep, we did. Let's go ahead and just buy a cheap aircraft here. And then we'll set the line right there, all the way over to Santa Barbara. There you go, that's one line set up, and we'll actually get money for doing that line per month. Bottleneck than anything. There we go. Phoenix is doing pretty good. We can add a couple more max to that, probably three. Line 13. So we already got some fuel being delivered. Let's go take a look at that. If I can find it down here. So this guy's actually producing, which is good. Let's see, do we need two ships yet? There's only 28 waiting there. We're going to this one next, which is only 44. So now one ship's good for the time being. We have one truck going back and forth. I could probably add another truck. Let's go ahead and add one more truck. I think it's a kind of a waste of money, but it'll be good eventually. There we go. And we're delivering construction material over here, which is good as well. Only got one truck running. Probably get another two trucks right there. There we go. Let's see, how much are we picking up right now? 86, this holds 100, so we're still good on that. I think the route to the Grand Canyon's going okay. We've got 9 people waiting, so we don't need to upgrade that. Just upgraded the taxi, so hopefully that will be okay. Go and speed it up a little bit. A couple more max run this line. Just help out this flow just for a second. Guys are all carrying stuff, which is good. Let's see if we're actually making machines. I need to add another truck to the machine route, it looks like. Go ahead and set up 2 for the time being. All right, things are going pretty good. Let's look at this route, see how it's going. Still need to bring more food back. It's line 8. Looks like these trucks are keeping up fairly well. So I'll hold off on adding any more there for the time being. All right, so we already got the industry boom medal right here, which we haven't even gone over the medals quite yet. So ensure that the number of industrial jobs in Los Angeles grows to 600. That's just by delivering these machines. You can do that. Make sure at least 12 terminals are built, which we can go ahead and start doing that here in a minute. Own the landing permissions for all airports, which we're working on right now. Own at least 20 planes at the end of the mission. And it says finish the mission before 1943. So we can actually add terminals by doing that. You just click here. Clicked on the wrong thing. Yeah, click on the airport, go to upgrade. Just hit 3 terminals. Cost 338K, not bad. We can go ahead and do that. And we can go ahead and upgrade the terminal up here in Phoenix as well. Again, it's not really needed. We don't have anybody waiting at the airport to even go anywhere on this particular journey. Let's see. We should have quite a bit. 61 crude oil coming in. That should hopefully ramp up production at the oil refinery. Let's see how much do we have waiting at this guy right here. 64. Could buy another ship. I'm going to hold off for the time being, though. We're still making fuel. Making really, really good time, as you can see. To finish the mission, we have to do it before 1943. Let's see how this boat's doing, though. Only 45 waiting there. That's fine. Go ahead and add one more guy right here. It's going pretty good. So we're max production right here. Hopefully we'll end up upgrading the steel mill here in the near. There you go, just upgraded right there. So now the max would be 200, which is going to increase the max of the mines in turn. Again, just keep supplying more trucks as you need to each of these lines. Good. You can see we're actually making pretty good money just by these simple truck routes. We need to add some more for the food one as well. Here's line 8. I think that's good. Probably add another truck or two to the machines if we needed to. And then we can add a couple more on the steel line. Got iron ore backing up. We go. So you can see we're delivering machines, 62 of 100, delivering fuel, 76. So we're almost completing all these little missions, and we'll set up the rest of the four lines. These mines are really, really ramping up how much we got to pick up. So just got to try to keep up to the best of your ability. Again, you could probably run a train line if you wanted to, but it's just easier to buy the trucks, in my opinion. All right, everything's going pretty good. We're really close on delivering the machines, 92. Actually, we just got one delivered construction material, which is up here. We may have to actually buy another boat. Let me go ahead and slow it down and see what we have in the station. So 85, that's still okay. We'll leave one boat going. And then we can go ahead and upgrade this guy to 3 terminals. We can go ahead and buy a aircraft as well. Just buy the cheap junkers and we'll set up a line. This will be going down to Santa Barbara. I'm not sure if we can set up one to from Las Vegas over to Phoenix, if that would actually work or not. I'm going to try it though, just in case. So buy another one. Set line right there to... There we go. Yeah, that counted. So I wonder if we can go ahead and set up... That's one line. Then we need one more airport to set up the fourth line. Pretty sure. Let's go ahead and speed it up. We're almost there on the machines part, so... Go. Again, go ahead and upgrade to 3 terminals. Got the gold medal for make sure at least 12 terminals are built. And we could set up another line, so let's pause it or slow it down a little bit. Let's set up another line. Fourth line set up. And just for the heck of it, let me see if I can set up one more line. Not sure if this will give us more money or not. Okay, yeah, set up 5 lines right there. Okay, we gotta go ahead and pay a fine right here. $2 million, not a problem since we're making plenty of money. Again, those planes are... Oh, we'll see what this is. Aircraft 5 has a problem. No path. Okay, let's see. Let's go take a look at it and see what I was trying to do. So line 22 maybe messed up. Why would it say no path? Line 2... So it's going from LA to San Diego. Not sure why there'd be no path. Let's go ahead and just send it to Phoenix then, I guess. I don't know. There we go. Still have 5 lines set up. And it's always good to look at your lines to see what's making the most money and what's not making money. The planes are going to be the biggest drain on our accounts, and you can see our iron ore line is making quite a bit along with the coal, and then you can see the steel down there in the machines as well. Those will all pick up considerably the more we do of it. Go ahead and speed it up real fast. Everything's going good. Haven't taken out a loan yet either. Really shouldn't be needed. So last thing we gotta do is deliver fuel. Just down here. And now's the time where you might wanna run 2 separate ships if you want to. We can go ahead and change this line real fast. We'll take off Phoenix Central. In fact, let me just remove everything, make it easier. Go ahead. Nope. I took off the coal, unfortunately, or the crude oil that was waiting. We're going to buy another one. It's my bad. I shouldn't have got rid of everything. Now it's restarting the whole process, which is not a big deal. I mean, we're already making plenty of money. It's just going to delay delivering the fuel, if anything. We should easily get to 100 with already what's in here, so shouldn't be a problem. Oh, let's go ahead and fix this while we're here. Can add a few more taxis. All right, so we got landing permission at that airport, which is down here. We already paid off our loan, the penalty, it looks like. I know we still have to generate more cash. So basically generate enough cash to pay off the rest of the fine, which we need, looks like 14 million from the looks of it. Shouldn't be a problem. So we need the DC-3. There we go. This is what's actually going to cost a lot of money. I don't know if I want to start the process now. I guess I could. Let's go and see if we can take out a loan if we buy enough of these. There we go. Take out a loan for $8 million, which gets us closer to our payoff. And let's go ahead and set these guys up on a line. Same line, I guess, is the only issue. Let's just try that out. Hopefully it does enough. And hopefully it's not too much of a drain on our account right now, so we start losing money. I don't think it should be. Okay, keeping up with the mines from the looks of it. Keeping up with the steel, and we should be keeping up with the machines as well. There it goes. Should be fine. So we basically have 10 plus years to transport 300 people. Again, I'm not sure if the line that I just set up is actually adequate for what we want to do, but we can always adjust it in 2 or 3 years if we need to for any reason. And now is probably the time where we want to get these single aircraft back in, because they're just wasting money. There's no real reason to have them at all. So I'm going to go ahead and have them come back into the depot and we'll sell them all. That way they're not draining our expenses, because they can only carry one person. It's kind of pointless to have them. Go to depot. Depot for you as well. go. That should be all the ones that are really draining our accounts. And you could start a train line to transport all sorts of stuff, whether it be passengers or machines between the cities. Again, not really needed as long as you have pretty good economy. And it looks like we're already transporting people into DC3, which is good. We do need to ramp up our taxis in here. I'm not sure where these guys want to go, though. It's a good question to see. Basically, they want to get on line 13, so we need to add some more guys to line 13 from the looks of it. Go to add a few more max. There we go. And we could actually add a few going to the Grand Canyon as well for some more money, which those are the Snyders. Probably line 14, I'm assuming. Yep, line 14. Like, we need to ramp up how many vehicles we have going to our mines. I need to add a couple more for the steel route as well. One set up. And probably add one or two more for the machine route as well, since we're at it. Should be, I think, line 4. Yeah. That line seems to be doing okay. We got passengers waiting at different airports already, which is good. Hopefully that's not draining money on my account. Grand Canyon line's still going pretty good from the looks of it. Should fill the people up. 10 of 10, yeah, it did. I guess it's picking people up, you just can't see because there's so many people waiting there. Probably need to add a few more. to the Grand Canyon route. So we got a problem. Let's go see what's wrong. Try to ship more from the construction site. So let's go take a look at it real fast. Is it full or what? Oh, so we don't have anything coming in. The ship's only 80% full. I guess we could run another ship. It's kind of pointless, though. Oh, because this doesn't need anything, so let's send these guys home. In fact, let's see if we can get this. Something that needs even... Oh, I got an idea. If that doesn't need bricks, I know that something in Vegas does need bricks. So we'll just change the line around a little bit. Go ahead and select another bus stop. And then what we'll do for this line is we'll actually change the endpoint to over here. That way we can keep this line open and going. What line was that? 16, I think. Yeah. There we go. So that should go off here in a minute. So we're transporting people. I'm not sure if it's going to be enough. We're already 23 of 300. I'm going to check it in 2 years to see where we're at. How many people on that? 7 of 8. So I think we're doing okay. I don't think these guys are making money, but we'll find out. Look at that train. Beautiful. Okay. Made some decent money right there, picking people up. Is this guy full too? No, 0 of 8 on that guy. You can see the steel mill's already been upgraded again. You can see how much bigger it is now. And the max currently is 400, which is pretty insane. See how much traffic we have coming into, which is pretty crazy. So doing good. We're almost paying back the loan. We're already over 10 million again. And we're already at about 40 people transported in the DC-9. Which is a beautiful aircraft. I just don't see airlines in this case being profitable. Here's where we could probably believe, oh, we got two ships going, so that's good. This one's just loading up, 82. Let's see how this is going. Probably need a couple more going to the Grand Canyon. There we go. Obviously a pretty profitable line right there. In fact, let's take a look at it. I think it was line 13. Yeah, it's actually negative currently. We got plenty of people waiting. I guess it's probably the type of vehicle that we use. Probably should have gone with the lesser vehicle. Either way, our only big drag right now is 121K negative with the four airplanes, which again is not too bad. In fact, we probably could add a couple to the line here in a minute. Going to add two more DC-9s. Look at the amount of traffic, it's pretty crazy. Streamline Coach New Mexico. I got some pretty cool trains on here. I wish I was actually running trains back and forth right now. See how profitable these trucks are. I'm kind of curious about that. Look at that. Each truck's about 30,000 per year. I don't know how many trucks we have on the line, but it's quite a lot, as you can see. Production's definitely ramping up, which is good. And we may need a couple more to transport the steel over. Probably one or two more for the machines. Go ahead and get this out of the way, and then we'll stop buying stuff for a while. Try to get back up to 10 million. Ooh, look at that traffic. And if you wanted to, I've done it before, but you could actually make a big bus station in each city and have buses transport people from each city. I wouldn't say it's all that profitable, but it's not necessarily a bad thing either. There you go. Finally got some materials there. May have to upgrade that route in a little bit. Got plenty of bricks. Let's go ahead and add a couple more guys here. Click on these guys, get them to turn around. There we go. We have to add another ship on there at some point. So these guys are probably breaking even from the last time I looked. I don't know why guys are still flying. There is one more thing we have to do. We have to be able to buy 20 aircraft. So I forgot about that. We're doing okay on the passengers delivered so far. I'm not too concerned with it. Still got a small guy flying somewhere. I'm not even sure where it went. Is that him? Yeah, we want him to go in the depot because he's just wasting money. Look at this. We need more. Jesus. Look at that backup right there. Might be time for an actual train once we pay off this penalty. Set up a new line or not to keep this from happening. Maybe just set up wider roads if I had to. I could probably fix this. I could do trains back and forth. I could set up a second route to stop here instead of at this one, which would help hopefully alleviate some of the traffic. Things are going okay. Got 100 plus people in 1936. We again have until 1943. So I think we're going to be okay on that. And we got to own at least 20 planes. I'm not sure quite how many we own. Let's look real fast. Find the planes here. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we need 9 planes. We got 10 million right now. Really want to pay off that loan. But we could get this out of the way too if we had to. Plane's full, which is good. Let's see, let's go ahead and do this. Until we get the metal. There we go. Actually, what we're going to do is sell them. Because we don't need them. We should have some more somewhere that we can sell if I can find them. I don't think I sold them quite yet. Maybe we don't. Okay, maybe I did sell them already. Check one more time. Alright, we do need to increase the amount of trucks going to there. Back up anymore. I think we're pretty close to finishing the scenario. I don't know if I should add a couple more planes or not. I'll probably wait till I pay off the penalty first, then maybe buy another plane or two just to be on the safe side. But we're almost to 200 people, and we've got plenty of time to go. Again, all we have to do is finish this mission before 1943, and it's looking like we will. Production of the steel mill is going up quite a bit. Eight of eight people, which is good. There's that little guy I've been looking for. Definitely get rid of you. So close to paying off the loan. I could buy more trucks for the certain routes if I wanted to, but let's give it a minute. Making pretty good money. This would be a good time to set up train lines if the mission went any farther, but it doesn't. Definitely set up a train line to deliver the steel over there, get rid of the trucks. Add train lines to deliver materials would help out. Or you could even make the road wider if you really wanted to. Just keep adding more and more trucks. Let's go see how our fuel is going. Good, no fuel in there, which is good. Probably a little bit of overkill on the amount of trucks we have going back and forth. Look at that, 44 people waiting. Let's see if we're actually negative on the... Yeah, you can see there, negative 300,000 on the plan line, and it's full, 51 of 51 people being transported. All right, penalty's almost paid off. So we can start buying another aircraft or two to make sure we hit the 300 people before 1943. There you go, penalty's paid off. I think there's actually, can you actually upgrade the airport? I didn't know that, let me click on that. Oh no, I've already upgraded the terminals. Thought there was another plane that would come along sometime in this mission that holds a little bit more people than eight. It's about $1 million per plane, so I'll wait till we get a little bit above a million before buying another plane. We're already at 250 people, and we don't need a loan. No point in that. Again, I could have done this mission without taking out that first $8 million loan. I didn't really need it per se, but it does help out a little bit to pay off that $14 million. Alright, let's go ahead and buy one more plane. He's waiting there, 119. See, we could, this is where we could send another ship down this way or upgrade the ship. It's already 150 waiting right there. Anyways, no point in upgrading or adding more ships or doing anything with the lines. There's no need to. Because we just need a couple more people delivered, which will easily happen before 1943. There it goes. So that's how you beat this mission with all 5 medals at once. Again, there's 100 different ways you guys could do that out there. That's just simply the easiest. It seems like doing the truck routes and building up the trucks as much as possible is the most profitable way to do things. Of course, adding a train or two couldn't hurt. And I'm sure you could make way more money than I did at the end of the scenario just by doing a couple train routes. Anyways, that's the Middle Age Gamer. I definitely hope you appreciate this video and the tutorial. And I'll catch you guys on the next video. Take care, everybody.